It's time for The Match Game, Hollywood Squares, our quiz from St. Elsewhere, Christina Pickles. From Too Close for Comfort, Lydia Cornell. From Happy Day, Anson Williams. Charles Nelson Reilly. Phyllis Diller. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rivers and John Bowman.
Done it again.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, all right.
Much better.
It's so sensitive. It's so sensitive.
Yes, right.
My gosh.
When you made your entrance, did you shake your fringe?
I forgot.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank you. Listen, Christina, when we saw each other in the dressing room at the beginning of the day, I didn't greet you properly, because I thought you'd been on the show before. We've had so many people staying elsewhere. I thought we'd had you, so I want to give you a proper greeting. You must come back more often and pretend you're a stranger.
I'd like to.
I'm very upset.
Why, Charles? What's wrong?
Because when they found out they were going to sit next to me, I heard them in the hall say, "Let's go in mourning."
And they did.
Well, that's what they said.
You're not in mourning, are you?
Sitting next to Charles.
All right, would all of you join me, please, in giving a brisk, hearty welcome here to our two players, Linda Smith and Jody Lechner. Hello there. We're going to get acquainted with them right now, beginning with Linda. Tell us a little bit about you, please.
Okay, well, I'm originally from Salt Lake City, Utah. I came out here about 2 years ago to study acting. I'm currently teaching English at a school of languages. I'm single, but best of all, I am madly in love. And that's about...
That's great. It's a wonderful feeling, isn't
it? Yes, it is.
A big kiss.
Okay. Why not? I've just ruined your whole future. All right, good luck to you here, Linda, and good luck in your personal life, too. Now, Jody, we've seen you before. You
yes,
were on this program once, and there was some irregularity. I don't remember what it was, a dispute about a question or something. So we thought, in all fairness to you, we ought to ask you back here, and that's why you're here. Now, would you refresh our memories, please, on where you're from and all that sort of thing?
Okay, right now I'm living in Azusa. I attend Azusa Pacific University. I'm hoping to get my bachelor's degree in business by December. I also work part-time in a major department store in a personnel office, and I enjoy skiing and sailing.
Okay, nice to have you here. Back again.
Thank you.
Good luck to both of you. We'll play three rounds of the Match Game. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Linda won the toss. She'll go first.
A, please.
All right, Linda. Okay. This is what it says. Hugh Hefner said.
Yes.
You know who he is.
Huey, sure.
Hugh, right.
Who Hugh?
He said, "I don't think Miss January is an intellectual."
No.
"She even moves her lips when she reads a blank." Put it in the slot, Christina, and away we go. Hugh Hefner said, you know who he is, don't you? He said, "I don't think Miss January is an intellectual. She even moves her lips when she reads a blank." You seem to be puzzled by this.
I am puzzled.
Really?
I guess I'll say a picture book.
Well, I guess you really didn't understand the question.
Give her a break.
Well, she didn't understand it.
Give her a break.
All right, Lydia, what have you got?
Okay, took a lot of thought, but...
Oh, yes.
A billboard.
A billboard.
Get it? Because you have to...
Give her a break.
Come on.
That's not bad.
Give her a break. Billboard
is
not bad.
You're supposed to register right away when you see a billboard.
You had to be there.
Right.
This could be a match if they're generous. Comics.
Comics.
Good.
not generous today. Judges.
What did you finally come up with?
Well, it's my first time. I hope it's okay. Road sign.
Road sign is perfect. Yeah, perfect. Road sign is an excellent response. Or anything in that field. What do you got, Joe?
Oh, I'm right in the same field. I said stop sign.
There is a wonderful answer. Stop sign.
Yeah.
How nice of you to agree.
Anson?
Well, you know, she's really... I know Miss January is a very careful driver, because you never know who's in the car, but stop sign.
Stop sign is good. Lady with the fringe.
It's too bad one of these guys isn't playing with us two or something. Stop sign.
There it is. Okay. You got the idea now,
Lydia. Got it now.
All right.
Yes.
Jody, this is what we have for you. Tippy the tourist said, "Boy, that Burbank circus is boring. Instead of a lion tamer, they have a blank tamer." Boring. Boring.
Burbank circus.
Yes, boring. Here we go. Tippy the tourist said, "Boy, that Burbank circus is boring. Instead of a lion tamer, they have a blank tamer."
A mouse tamer?
Mouse tamer is good, Jody. Mouse is all right.
Oh, boy. We are not on the same wavelength. Turtle tamer.
A turtle tamer. That's boring. Charles?
Close, but no cigar. A flea trainer.
Another good one.
Trained fleas.
Yes. Say it.
Mule.
Mule. All right.
Mule tamer. Well, as long as we're here in Burbank, I thought I would say an NBC executive tamer. But that's boring and difficult. But I crossed that out and I went instead with the canine feline family dog.
Dog.
You know.
All right.
Lion dog.
So far, no mouse, which is not a bad answer.
No.
Yeah, we're not doing so hot, huh?
No mouse.
No.
Well, I guess we'll just have to improve that. Mouse.
Mouse. There you go. Go, Phyllis.
With Anson's and mine, it's mice.
Uh-huh. That's two for you. So that makes the score 2-0 in your favor, Jody. We'll go to round 2 right after this for you. Round 3. Jody, your head, you go first.
Okay, I'll stick with B.
All right, 4 people play. The upper tier and John. Wanda said,
"The good news is, I've been accepted into celebrity charm school. The bad news is, the school is run by blank."
Come over to Jody. Wanda said, "The good news is I've been accepted into celebrity charm school. The bad news is the school is run by blank."
This is tough. How about Phyllis Diller?
Really?
Whoa, what is this? I thought that's what you wanted.
Yes, just want to make it feel good. What do you say, Lydia?
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell is a good one.
Dean Don Rickles of the show.
Don Rickles. That's right. All right, Christina.
Joan Rivers.
Joan Rivers. So far, no one said Phyllis Diller. What do you say?
Don't look at me, pal.
You ain't going to say it, are you?
I wouldn't insult our lovely celebrity on the end. I said Howard Cosell.
It is. All right. Now, Linda, you got a little catching up to do. Let's see if you do it here. The Beverly Hills Insane Asylum is such a ritzy place. I'm going to send about half of you there. It's such a ritzy place, the patients wear blank with their straitjackets. You ready, Lydia? Play in the slot. Changing your mind. Now, are you ready, Linda?
I think so.
I'll give it to you one more time. Beverly Hills Insane Asylum is such a ritzy place that patients wear blank with their straitjackets.
I have two thoughts. I think I'll go with ties.
Ties? All right. Okay, something for Mr. Guy or one of those places. What do you say?
Gucci.
They wear Gucci something.
It was going to be diamonds.
Gucci shoes or whatever.
She means actual Mr. Gucci.
I said black tie.
Black tie. Christina.
And I said diamonds.
She said diamonds. All right. Girl's best friend. 2-1 the score, John.
And I said Gucci belts.
Very good one. She said ties. What have you got there?
Well, when I'm in that hospital, personally, I wear diamonds.
Diamonds.
Great answer, right on national TV.
What do you say, Miss Diller?
I'm wrong. I said pearls.
You said pearls. It's all right. So it's 2-1 now at the end of round two, and we'll go to round three. This is our final round coming up right after this. All right, here we go with the third and final round. Jody, you're still ahead. You go first.
Okay, so I'm going to continue with B.
All righty. The upper tier in John.
Mm-hmm.
If you're ready for this. The organ grinder's monkey said. I don't know how they talk, but he said, I'm sick of working for a nearsighted organ grinder. Yesterday, instead of the organ, he tried to crank my blank. That's good. Yeah. All right, Christina, ready. Jody, here we go. The organ grinder's monkey said, I'm sick of working for a nearsighted organ grinder. Yesterday, instead of the organ, he tried to crank my blank.
I'm going to go with tail.
Tail it is. All right, let's see if we get any tails over here.
Finally.
Lydia.
Okay, this is a joke, but setting it up like that won't work. Rump. Ha, ha, ha. And then tail.
Tail. All right.
I was going to go with the rump joke, but I thought, no. Tail.
You said tail.
Tail.
Tail. All right. I didn't say anything. What do you got for us, Jim?
Hey, you know, if we had enough of those insult rump jokes, we could have a rump roast. Thank you. But I said tail.
Six. Wow.
I like to manipulate them. Boost.
Now, Linda, the best you could do is achieve a tie. You can do that, however, by matching the five celebrities whom you've not matched up to date. George said, I'll never go back to Weird Willie's bar. Instead of using shaved ice, Willie shaves his blank into the drinks. Here we go, Linda. Everybody's ready over there. George said, I'll never go back to Weird Willie's bar. Instead of using shaved ice, Willie shaves his blank into the drinks.
Beard.
Beard is what she says. Now, you need five to achieve a tie. Lydia, what do you say?
Beard.
Beard. There's one. 5-2 to score. Christina, what do you say?
Whiskers. Is that
all right,
beard?
That's it. 6-3. John?
I said beard.
6-4. What do you say, Anson? You gonna break the spell?
We were going pretty good, weren't we?
Yeah, we were.
Now we're doing better.
Okay, 6-5. Phyllis.
Hey, baby.
Hey! Well, that gives us a tie. Now we have to go to the tie-breaking question. And I will read you the tiebreaker, which says... Big blank. That's B-I-G blank. Big blank. Think about it over there. Now, in front of you here, but out of sight of the stars, are four pretty good responses to that. Your seats were chosen by lot. Jody, you're going to go first. Tell me by number which of the four answers you would like to fill in that blank. Big blank. Number one, two, three, or four?
Three.
You want number three? All right. You're going to get that one. And Linda, of the remaining ones, which one do you want?
Number two.
Number two is yours. I'm going to go over here and canvass the stars, get their verbal responses. As soon as you hear your answer, please let me know in some very audible, demonstrative way. Lydia, what do you say?
Big Apple.
Big Apple is not there. Well, my favorite city, Charles?
Big Boy.
Big Boy is not there. Neither one of them has that. Christina, what do you say?
Big Whopper.
Big Whopper. No?
Explain that.
No, we don't want to explore that any further. John?
Miss Pickles. Big Deal.
Big Deal is not there. No.
Shockaroo.
All right.
I got it.
You got it?
I got it.
What?
Big Foot.
Oh. Big Foot!
I would have taken it.
There it is. All right, come on down, Linda. Now, right over here, if you would, please. Jody, it was a pleasure to see you again.
Thank you.
We got some gifts from the match game. Jody Lechner, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, congratulations. How do you feel?
Pretty good.
Good.
Great.
I'm very happy for you. Now we're going to switch over to Hollywood Squares. Here comes the rest of our set. Our stars will be out in a moment or so. John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive an energy-saving portable dishwasher with 7 push-button controls. Provides up to 18 cycle selections, hardwood cutting board top, and concealed rollabout casters furnished by White Westinghouse. It's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares, our win from Hotel Nathan Cook. From Falcon Crest, Abby Dalton. From Fame, Carlo Imperato. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
Coming on, the show is younger than Carlo Imperato. And we will be back to play Hollywood Squares in just a minute. Be there.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
And here she is, Linda Smith, who has done it. Do you know Bigfoot personally?
I do.
Too. Mm-hmm. She said that she would have, had she chosen first, taken the other response. So she considers herself, in a way, lucky to have gotten through the match game into Hollywood Squares. Congratulations to you. You played very well. We have 3 brand new celebrities. They are Carlo Imperato, Abby Dalton, and Nathan Cook. Abby, you and I were talking a little bit earlier, and you just took quite a lengthy trip. You didn't make it quite all the way around the world.
Yes, I did.
Oh, you did?
Circumnavigated the world. It's called Circumnavigation Aggravation. I think that's the title of a new song. You know, I was aggravated in every country around the world, except for England. I really did enjoy England.
Well, it's nice for us that you made your way around the world and are back here with us. As far as you are concerned, Linda Smith, you and I have a bit shorter trip over here to play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And before we begin today's contest, we will reacquaint ourselves with our defending champ. His name is John Cervenka. His total in one day, $1,300. Good for you.
Thank you.
So now today is the day. Yesterday, John pulled the big 3-0 and had the question blank Fitzgerald. To which John kind of blanked on Fitzgerald and came up with Patrick Fitzgerald. He did promise us that he would come in today and tell us who Patrick Fitzgerald, in fact, is. Do you have that response, John?
I have no idea who the man is. None whatsoever.
But he did tell me outside that one of the NBC pages said that they also would have said Patrick Fitzgerald. So that unfortunately doesn't count for anything. But Patrick, if you're watching out there, please call in and tell us who you are. Anyway, you played very, very, very well in the Hollywood Squares portion of our show yesterday. So let's see if you can get through it one more time and maybe make it to that super match again and give it another crack. Linda Smith, you are going to have something to say about that. We will play this game until you hear the time. Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point wins the game, of course, and goes on to play Supermatch, which can be worth up to that magic $30,000 figure. Our first game is worth $100, $25 for every square, and John Cervenka, you're the champ. Pick
Gene.
A star, and let's go.
Gene, please.
Mr. Rayburn,
yes,
you're an All-American guy looking around for a 22-year-old girl.
Yes, of course.
And a heart condition.
Are most of the 22-year-old women in this country already married? Or are most of them still single?
Most of them are still single, and probably seniors in college.
Academic status has little to do with this, John. He says most of them are still single. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
Most of them are still single. You are right to agree. You get the first square. Linda Smith, you're playing O. Pick a star.
I'll go with Charles.
Charles Nelson Reilly. You're in London, and you just got a job as a dustman. Do you remove lint from the Queen's clothing, or are you a garbage collector?
I would say I was a garbage collector. I don't think they let the Queen's things get that dirty these days. I mean, they got Martinizing over there.
He says a dustman is a garbage collector. What do you say, Linda Smith? Agree or disagree?
I'm going to disagree.
A dustman is a garbage collector. You should have agreed with Charles. No, he knew his sanitation engineers. John Cervenka, good break for you. Pick a star on your own.
Nathan for the win.
This will give you the first game. Nathan Cook from Hotel.
Yes.
Your eyebrows grow together in the middle. Mm-hmm. And give you that rugged caveman look. According to the book, The Professional Image, is that a good look for a man? Or would you improve your appearance if you plucked some of those hairs out?
Well, I mean, if it's his job, I mean, if the guy's an accountant or something, you don't want to, you know, ape accountant or anything. I gotta go with pluck 'em. Come on. I mean, eyebrows all the way across? Pluck 'em!
This is the most entertained a contestant has ever been by a question. John, can you concentrate? He says you would improve your appearance if you plucked out some of those hairs. Agree or disagree for the game?
I agree.
You would improve your appearance if you plucked some of those hairs out. You're right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. You're not only having a good time. You're playing pretty well. 175 for the champ, nothing for the challenger. So far, it is early yet. We will be back to find out what happens in a $200 game after this.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
175 for the champ, nothing for the challenger. They're both having a great time, but especially John. You're really just having a terrific time. In the commercial break, you say, hey, ridiculous. The guy is an accountant, goes to work, and he has this big, long eyebrow in the middle of his head, goes around like a sweatband? What are you talking about? All right, John, we will do the jokes. Linda, you will pick a star for an O.
Charles, please.
Charles Nelson Reilly. It's time to start teaching your child the facts of life. According to Ann Landers, is it a good idea to start by telling him about the birds and the bees? Or should you just get right down to the nitty-gritty?
I could get the same look, rugged look of the one eyebrow if I put the toupee on about 3 inches forward. I get that same look. When I was a dustman in England, I used to do that. I would get right down to it, because that other way is out now.
Get right down to the nitty-gritty.
You get right down to it and...
Gotcha.
11 minutes.
Agree or disagree, Linda?
I agree.
You should get right down to the nitty-gritty. You are right to agree, and you're on the board. Good for you. Point of fact, interesting. Kids are actually confused by birds and bees talk. Actually confused by it. John Cervenka, pick a star for an X.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
All righty.
According to a recent Gallup poll, do most adults in America have sore feet? Or did most Americans say their feet were just fine? Thank you.
Foot problems, that's one of those hereditary things. I mean, women think they get bad feet from wearing high heels. That's not true. It's purely hereditary. And I think all of us suffer from corns and bunions and sore feet. As a matter of fact, you mind if I take my shoes off? No, I think most people have sore feet.
He says most people in America, most adults have sore feet. What do you say, John?
I disagree.
most adults in America do have sore feet. No, you should have agreed with Gene, and your opponent gets that square almost 75%
John,
of all
Americans
over 18.
I'd just like to announce that Dr. Rayburn will be speaking in Santa Monica at the Firehouse the 11th and 14th.
Thank you.
On fingernails and thumbs.
Pick a star, Linda Smith, for an O.
Nathan, to win, please.
This would give you the second game and
the lead.
Oh,
my goodness.
Do any fish grunt? Or are they all silent?
Fish make a lot of sounds. I don't know about grunting, but since they do make sounds and they're not silent, I don't know if we can hear them, but I'm going to say there are grunting fish, yes.
He says, some fish grunt. Agree or disagree, Linda?
I agree.
Some fish grunt. You are right to agree. You get the square, and you win the game, and you take the lead. All right, the plot has thickened. Challenger is ahead. We are zipping right along. However, we will clear the three O's off of the board. We'll move right on to the next game. This game is worth $300, and we're going to start it with the champ, John Cervenka. Pick a star.
I'll pick Gene again, please.
Gene Rayburn.
I'm ready.
Country singer Loretta Lynn says her house is filled with these. Are they chickens or ghosts?
Well, she wouldn't have chickens around the house. You know, they make doo-doo on the couch and all that, and wouldn't want to do that.
This is Gene's next lecture.
Yeah, so I'd say it would be ghosts. She must live in some historical house down south or someplace.
Agree or disagree, John? Loretta Lynn's house is filled with ghosts, Gene says.
I agree.
Loretta Lynn says her house is filled with ghosts. You are right to agree, and you get the first square. Sure. The coal miner's great-grandmother, the coal miner's great-grandfather. Sure. Linda Smith, pick a star for an O.
Carlo.
For me?
Yes.
That's you.
Wake up, Carlo.
Hi.
Is there anything that will get a chicken to move 30 miles an hour?
A good kick.
Or is there no way a chicken can move that fast?
If you drag him, tie him to the back of your car. I don't.
He's mean.
I'd say with not using physical strength, you can't move a chicken.
You can't get him to move 30 miles an hour on his own.
I could, but you couldn't.
Oh. Carlo says, I believe if I am interpreting this correctly, that you cannot get a chicken to move 30 miles an hour under his own power. Agree or disagree, Linda?
I agree.
There is no way a chicken can move that fast. You are right to agree, and you get the square. Good for you. John Cervenka, there's an X and an O on the board, and you are playing X. Pick a star.
Charles, please.
See, Carlos and I were both born in the Bronx, so if you don't like the way we talk, we could beat up everybody. Of course, Carlos would go first.
Charles, you're throwing a very large party. Now, according to etiquette expert Letitia Baldridge...
I don't like her.
Is it okay to invite a man and a woman who are divorced from each other? Or should you avoid it like you'd avoid World War III?
Well, I know a restaurateur who... the biggest problems in restaurants is that if you have to forget who's divorced and sit them next to each other. So carrying that over into a private dinner party, I think you should avoid it like the plague.
Or World War III.
I know that when I go to the dustmen's parties in England, they try to do that.
Charles says that at a very large party, you should avoid inviting a man and a woman who are divorced from each other. Agree or disagree, John?
I disagree.
At a large party, it's okay, according to Letitia Baldridge. You are right to disagree, and you get the square. The large party is the key here, yes. At a small party, take World War III. We'll be back to find out what happens in our $300 game and for the day after this. Stick with us. $300 for the challenger, $225 for the champ. What that means in simple terms is that we got a very, very close game, and everything is riding on this third segment. Linda Smith, pick a star.
Nathan DeBlock.
You missed this one. The game in the lead goes over to John. Remember on your tax form where it asks you if you want $1 to go to the presidential election campaign fund?
Tax form. Oh, yeah. Go ahead, what?
Yeah. Now, what did President Reagan do on his tax return? Did he give the dollar or did he hold it back?
He held it back.
He says President Reagan did not give that dollar to the Presidential Election Campaign Fund. What do you say, Linda? Agree or disagree?
Disagree.
President Reagan held the dollar back. You should have agreed with Nathan. Your opponent gets that square and wins the game. All right. That's good for you, John. With a little help from Linda. But no matter, you have taken the lead, $550 to $300. However, we still have plenty of time. Sweep the X's and the O off of the board, and we're going to start a $400 game. So clearly you can take the lead if you win this one. Linda, pick a star.
Charles.
Charles Nelson Reilly. You've just been given the honorary degree of doctor.
From just man to doctor. Only in Hollywood.
According to Ann Landers, should you use your new title before your name, or is doing that a misleading and stupid thing to do?
It's misleading and stupid to do that. And it shouldn't be flaunted, just on the side, on the stationery.
Agree or disagree, Linda?
I agree.
It is misleading and stupid. And you are right to agree, and you get the square. Honorary, I think, is the key there. If you're an honorary doctor, just don't put it before your name. Your chance for an X, John.
Let's go with Gene again, please.
Okay, Mr. Rayburn.
Yes?
According to a recent Harris poll, would most American shoppers rather save money and stand on a long checkout line or pay more money and stand on a short checkout line?
It's short versus long.
I just said that, yes. You've got the long and short of it, Gene.
Yes. Well, I don't care what they say in Washington. People are having economic problems, you know, with the deficit and all. I'd say to save some money, they'd stand in a long line.
Agree or disagree with that, John?
I agree.
According to the recent Harris poll, most American shoppers would pay more and stand on a short checkout line, and you should have disagreed, and that certainly surprised me, too, when I looked at it. That is according to the recent Harris poll. All right. Linda Smith, big break in the game for you. Make your move.
Nathan to win, please.
This would give you the game and the lead back. You've got corroded bolts.
Bolts?
Bolts.
Okay.
B-O-L-T-S.
Yes, right.
According to Gloria Vanderbilt, you can loosen your bolts.
Gloria Vanderbilt?
Somehow Gloria Vanderbilt got on the subject of
bolts. What happened
to
Letitia?
Makes those jeans with bolts.
You didn't like her, so she left. You've got corroded bolts. According to Gloria Vanderbilt, you can loosen your bolts by soaking them in this. Is it vinegar or champagne?
Well, Gloria, I gotta go champagne.
He says, soak your corroded bolts in champagne. Agree or disagree, Linda, for the game?
I'm gonna disagree.
You can loosen your bolts by soaking them in vinegar. You are right to disagree. You get the square, and you win the game. And you regain the lead. This is about the most back-and-forth topsy-turvy squares game as far as lead changes that I can remember. Take the O's off of the board. It's a $500 game. We will start it with you, John Cervenka. Every square counts. Pick a star.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
I'm ready.
Who's older, Dolly Parton or High Beam Headlights?
Yes. I don't think Dolly has ever been high. Well, let's see. High beam headlights. When do they come in? I'd say the high beam headlights are older than Dolly. Yes.
What do you say, John? Agree or disagree? High beam headlights are older than Dolly Parton. Yes, you are right to agree. You get the square. You got your high beams on. High beam headlights date back around 1915. Dolly born not much later, 1946. Pick a star, Linda Smith.
Carlo.
Carlo Imperato for an O. According to the book, Teenage Sexuality. What is most important to the average high school boy? Doing well in school or finding a girlfriend?
Talking about from the Bronx or where? Well, school is very important, but... Sorry, Mom. But the girls were definitely more...
Finding a girlfriend, he says.
Yeah.
Agree or disagree, Linda?
I agree.
According to the book, teenage sexuality, the most important to the average high school boy is doing well in school. You should have disagreed with Carlo.
You're talking about that.
I would have said finding a girlfriend who does well in school. The bell means that time is up. $775. Linda Smith, you are our new champ. Congratulations. Yeah. She's in shock. No, it was coming down to an issue where John could have taken the game and the lead, but we didn't quite get there. You have done it. $775. Zip your way over there with Gene Rayburn. Get set for your shot at the big money. Congratulations.
Well, we won some money.
Well, that's frustrating. That is frustrating. You would have had a shot at the $500 game in the lead, but still in all, when we get to a $500 game, that's pretty unusual. That means we've played a lot of questions on the day. You're a good champ. Our congratulations to John Cervenk, who's leaving here with a total of $1,900. Attaboy.
Thank you very much.
Take it away.
All right, here we are with a new champ. We'll be back with her and our nine stars to have a go at the really big money, the $30,000, right after this.
And now, here to play the Super Match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Here we are with Linda Smith. You remember Linda Smith, formerly known as Elizabeth Scott?
Yes. Huh? What?
Look
Say
at
it
her.
Again?
Look at her face.
That's yeah.
Right.
Elizabeth Scott.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Don't you think there's a slight resemblance?
Yeah. Exactly.
Yes. Exactly.
Who is Elizabeth Scott? Prettier.
Who is it? That's, thank
she
you,
was the second wife of Pat Fitzgerald.
Oh.
Right.
Oh.
Anyway, here
married
we are
a dust man in England.
With Linda. This is her first day here in the winner's place, and she's going to have a go at the $30,000 in the super match. We wish her well. Let's see how it goes. We polled an audience not too long ago, Linda, and we said write down your best answer to this. Tom Blaine. If you give us the answer they chose most often, we give you $1,000. If you choose our second most popular, $500. And $250 for the third, and any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here. Whom do you call on?
John.
I'm going to go with Tom Jones.
There's one for you.
Carlo.
Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry. You just left him this morning, didn't you?
It's a cartoon,
it's the Bronx.
Man.
It's the Bronx.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who Selleck. Else? Tom Selleck.
Tom Selleck.
Very nice.
Oh, that's a fun.
So you have Tom Selleck, Tom and Jerry, and Tom Jones. Now, you have to think about this carefully and decide if you want to choose one of those as the answer or if you'd like to think up one of your own.
I think you're right. I think I'll stick to Selleck.
You want Selleck?
Yeah, that's good, I think.
We all want Selleck, don't we? All right, we're going to find out now if Tom Selleck is up there. We'll begin at the bottom, and we will reveal the $250 response. Tom Jones is there. All right, that's John's answer. The $500 response says, Tom Selleck, you've got $500.
Oh, brother.
Now, what do you think's on top?
Sawyer.
What?
Turkey.
Tom, you think turkey's on top? Tom Turkey?
Tom Sawyer.
It's turkey.
Sawyer.
Sawyer.
Tom what?
Thumb.
Tom Thumb, yeah.
Sawyer.
She's
Tom
decided
Sawyer.
Finally that Tom she had a second chance, she would have chosen Tom Thumb. Is that what the audience says? Okay, slide the $1,000 response, please. Tom Thumb it is. Listen, that's not bad. You've got $500. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. After you've made your selection, that star will reveal the hidden number, and we will multiply your $500 by whatever number is revealed. Okay, Linda, time to choose a star.
I'll go with John.
Okay, John has a 10, a 20, or a 30. He had a 30 yesterday. It's random. We have no idea. Ready, set, go. A 10, so you're playing for $5,000. Now, face me, and here we go. Pay blank, that's P-A-Y blank. John made up his mind very quickly. Do you have an answer in mind? All right, You collect the $5,000 if you match John. What do you say?
Pay dirt.
Pay dirt. The audience says you're wrong. If you had a second chance, what would you say?
I can't think of anything.
If you can't, all right. Pay dirt was one possibility. John, she says pay dirt will match you. What do you say to that?
There's absolutely nothing wrong with pay dirt, and I wish that you and I could have hit it, but I went for the simpler thing that we would like to take home and is more immediately available to us, the paycheck.
Paycheck, yeah. Payday would have been another one. Yeah. Payday would have been another one. Well, listen, today has been a total loss for you because you got $1,275. How about that?
Great. It's great.
Okay. We'll be back with Linda and the Stars right after this. Now, we want to reveal the big number. Somewhere up there is one big number. Ready, set, go.
Pulley, boo, Yankee, Abby Dalton.
At it. The big 30. The big 30 there.
I wouldn't have matched either.
You haven't.
All right. No, she said she wouldn't
you
have.
You would have matched me, though.
Stars.
Say goodnight, Stars.
We won't see you tomorrow.
Night, Chrissy.
Tomorrow being
oh, that's right.
Tomorrow is the 4th of July. So we will not be here. NBC has something special planned for you. We will be here on Thursday. And then again on Friday, we will not be here because NBC has something special planned for you on that day. So have a safe, sane 4th of July, and we'll see you on Thursday, okay?
Okay.
Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow or Thursday or whenever you can get to it, okay? Bye.
John Bob would say, so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares there. Happy holidays!
A member of our studio audience will receive Commodore 64 computer featuring 64K memory, full-size keyboard, color graphics, sprite sound capability, music composer cartridge, and program reference guide furnished by Commodore. This is Gene Wood speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.